Hello, I'm Lewis Hallam, and thank you for tuning into From the Mic Stand from Mashgura. I'm going to play you a song from one of my inspirations that I talked about before, John Lennon. This is a song called Help.
Welcome back to From the Mic Stand. There was another great song tonight from Lewis Hallam. We've still got one final track from him, but our best keep updated on what's coming up on the From the Mic Stand show. On next week's show, we're going to be joined in the studio by a singer-songwriter from Stoke called Merriman. So yeah, really excited to have him on the show. And then on the 4th of March, we've got a special, which is going to be downstairs in Mash. We're going to have five artists performing. So far, we've got Gideon Conn, who is this unbelievable singer-songwriter. He's played up and down the country. His songs are so funny and entertaining, we thought we'd share it with the rest of you. Really going to enjoy that. And we've also got Charles Unwright already booked. I'm going to book some more artists to perform for you at that day. I mean, tonight almost feels like we've got a special. We've got a massive audience in tonight for Lewis. So yeah, it's been great to have a bit of an audience in the studio this week. So Lewis, I've really enjoyed your set so far. So what have you got coming up? Have you got any plans?
I plan to have some sort of music, whether it be just a few singles or like a little EP, in like the next couple of months.
Sure.
I need a bit of a, you know, a bit of a slap really, because you know I've had a couple, probably like a year where, you know, I could have been, you know, just knuckling down and getting loads of songs out, but you know, times have been pretty tough, so now that I think I've got the time and the, you know, like the drive and the motivation for it, I think I'm gonna rush to get something out in the next couple of months.
I mean, sometimes you can work forever on a song, and then sometimes you can do it and it just comes overnight. I guess depending on the track.
Yeah, I mean, I always have a problem because I think I try and force myself to be creative. So yeah. It's more like I'll be sat at home playing guitar, like, you know, maybe going through my set, and then I'll be like, right, I'll write a song.
Sure.
I don't feel like that's the way to do it. Yeah. So I've got a bit of a love-hate relationship.
Right.
Because it's kind of it frustrates me more than I get pleasure out of it sometimes. Yeah. You know what I mean? It's like if I sit down and try and write a song,
yeah,
it's not going to be that good. But it's normally like, you know, the songs that just kind of come out of nowhere, or like the melody you'll just get sort of walking down a street.
Sure.
The, you know, if you can stick that in your head, then that's normally where the good stuff comes.
So you're one of those people that's like 1,000 little notes and bits of songs on your phone or something.
I've got millions of verses and lines and stuff like that on my phone. It's like, whether they'll see the light of day, I don't know, but it's more, I think I more have like a self-confidence issue with most with most of my stuff, and hopefully that's something, you know, I break out of. Mm. But yeah, it's more like, yeah, if it doesn't sound good in my head or a certain way in my head, then I throw it away or leave it. Where
I think like every creative person, they go through that imposter syndrome. Yeah. I'm not quite good enough, and everyone will find out somehow.
Mm. Yeah, so it's kind of been battling with that, really. Mm. And yeah, I kind of need to get the sort of attitude where it doesn't really matter as long as people are listening to my music and, you know, I'm enjoying what I'm doing.
It doesn't really matter if you throw a few bad ones out, but like, you learn by doing the ones.
It's just more. I think it's just the fear of the unknown, really.
Yeah,
isn't it?
Sure.
I never want to release anything that's going to sound bad or like people won't like. And I think that's what scares me the most. Do you know what I mean?
If people do want to catch your music and they've enjoyed what they're listening to, are there live dates that you've got planning? Or?
Yeah. I mean, follow me on Instagram. It should literally at Lewis Hallam. At SoundCloud, I think it's Lewis Hallam with an extra M on the end.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure that's it. You'll find me if you search my name. You can also go and listen to my EP that I did 2 years ago on there. So yeah, that's all. That's the only music I've got out at the moment. Other than that, if you're local, just go to an open mic night and I will probably be there.
Sure.
Yeah. So. Yeah, that's it.
Great. So what are we
going to
end the show on tonight?
I'm going to play you something off my EP.
Yeah.
It's called Don't Waste My Time. I'm going to try and have a go at it. It's fairly high. I'm quite ill, so I'm going to give it my best shot. So
sure.
I apologize if it's not.
I'm sure it'll be great.
I hope so.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.